So if your energetic field is compromised and not healthy, then the pendulum has even more of an ability to manipulate you and damage you even further. And when I... And when I say pendulum, I am referring to anything, any entity, either grandiose entity like media, social media, politics, big faceless pendulums that you ultimately don't have any control over, or people pendulums in your life, right? People that are negative. Maybe this is a negative family member. Maybe it's a negative spouse or a boyfriend or a girlfriend, a negative friend. It could be a coworker. It could be somebody that you have to encounter on a daily basis. So it's anyone or anything that is going to bring you down in your layers of reality. So remember, I like to view that any given day, I have 10 layers of reality that I have access to. The top layer being my best, most absolute greatest version of reality. This is me hitting the wave of success. This is me getting all the things that I want. This is me living the life that I want and not getting completely ripped apart by pendulums, right? This is me killing it. This is me saying to myself, oh, this is the best version of reality that I could access today, right? And then there's the bottom track. And the bottom track is, you know, the induced transition, depression, anxiety, feeling as though life isn't delivering, feeling as though you're not in control of your reality or you don't have any success. So when pendulums have the most access to you is when you're down here. And in order to get up here, a couple of things need to happen. You need to learn how to protect your field around you, and you need to use and start to cultivate energy to help fuel you towards some of those higher lifelines. This is done via action, this is done via frequency, and this is done via behavioral, you know, new behaviors, new patterns, all that stuff. So if you're down here, you have most likely been compromised. I mean, obviously you've been compromised. Your energetic levels have been compromised by you not creating a protective barrier around you. And your energy is essentially just bleeding out everywhere, and you're not able to gain any standing momentum, progress to getting yourself up to some of these higher lifelines. So this is going to be my top 5 steps for helping you get out of this space if you are here, right? The endless negative energy attacks that keep you down on some of these lower lifelines. So the first thing that you need to do is clean your field. Another way of saying this is cleaning your layer of reality, right? Making choices. So first off, you have to wake up. I see myself, I see my reality. What are the different attributes to my reality that are not serving me? Again, take a proper assessment. This is you reconciling what your reality is made up of and what is possibly keeping you down here on some lower levels. So again, just to reiterate, when this channel is open, and the pendulum is just bleeding you dry of your energy, right? You do not have any energy to transurf your reality. You must figure out what is in your layer of reality that is causing this to happen. People, a professional thing, tuning in too much to the media and politics. What exactly is getting you down, okay? So once you have cleaned your layer of reality, and I know this sounds like a very, very easy step, like, oh, just clean your layer of reality, right? I mean, truth be told, this might be you leaving a relationship. This might be you cutting a parent off. This might be you choosing a new profession for yourself if your work environment is toxic. These are big, huge steps to take in your reality, but this is how it's done, right? You are probably not going to be able to transurf your reality if you acknowledge these different parts of your reality that are keeping you down, and then you don't go about managing them. So I'm gonna put a link below renegotiating the deal with the pendulum. This sometimes can be done. You can keep pendulums in your reality, just you sort of set the stage or set your tone for the relationship that you're gonna have with the pendulum and take more than what the pendulum is taking from you, right? You have to figure out a way to get the deal leaning more in your favor, where you're going to get more energy than the pendulum is getting from you. And this is actually pretty easily done once you learn how to do it. But again, I'll put the link below to that video. So once you have cleaned your field, cleaned your layer of reality, made the choices that you need to make to protect yourself, then it becomes about you maintaining awareness of future threats. This is sort of where I am now, right? I'm very protective of my field energetically because if something does penetrate my field and throw me off, then a lot of my endeavors that I need energy to keep going, that starts to suffer, right? So I'm very tuned in when a pendulum comes for me. I'm like, nope, not today, pendulum. I exercise my aura, my protective field, and I make certain that I rent myself out, or I remove myself from the situation, right? Or I give the pendulum what it needs so I can get it away from me, therefore protecting myself and my energy and keeping my momentum going towards these upper layers of reality, right? So recognizing future threats, big, 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 big one. 3, managing your energy. So keeping your energy circulating within your energetic or your aura or your field isn't only about you making certain that it's not being penetrated and your energy being extracted, but it's also about keeping your energy stimulated within your field so you have a lot of it. I don't manage the pendulums in my life and then just sit on the couch for 2 weeks watching Netflix, right? I make certain that I have my workout routine, my clean eating routine, doing the things that I need to do to keep my energy up. This helps me to strengthen this field and keep me in a prime position to continue moving through my reality and not being susceptible to anything negative, right? It's something to protect. When you have your energy really abundant and circulating, it becomes like, you know, a valuable resource that you want to look out and protect, right? So 4, value your field. Again, this is being a little bit redundant, but making certain that you understand the value of staying intact, making certain that you understand the value of your energy, making certain that you understand the value of what the pendulum is asking for, and then with awareness, deciding, is it worth giving to that pendulum or not? Is what the pendulum asking for, you know, maybe some sort of negative exchange, media coming for you and saying, hey, look over here, here's some negative news. Is that something of value to you? Or is your energetic field more valuable to to you. It all becomes a game, really. Is what I have now worth maintaining, or is there something to gain by doing business with this pendulum? A lot of times the answer is yes. So sometimes it is, right? Sometimes the equation can help you and your endeavors with the pendulum, right? Sometimes there is an advantage to dealing with the pendulum, but a lot of times, especially when it comes to negative information, it's not. So addressing first and foremost, is the exchange negative or is it positive? And if it is positive, then how can I be on the better end of the deal? So five, to wrap this video up, grow your protection. So again, Vadim Zeland offers us a lot of really cool meditations in the meditation playlist. I will put the link below. They're pretty awesome. And in the chapter energy in Reality Transurfing Steps 1-5, he talks a lot about energy and protecting your energy and all that stuff. But as soon as you have adopted a relationship with this idea, right? I have energy. I am a ball of energy if I choose to keep that energy for myself. I could also allow myself to be compromised and lose that energy, especially to pendulums not serving me. But if I understand what this equation is and the value that my energy has, the value in me keeping my energy, the value in me cleaning my layer of reality and recognizing future threats and managing my energy and all that stuff. And as soon as you can develop a really firm connection with this idea, it's almost like a red siren is going to go off when a pendulum starts to approach you with a negative energy attack. Again, a person, a professional relationship, a parent, a spouse, a big faceless pendulum media, social media. So as soon as that starts coming towards you, you can kind of go about feeling what your stance is going to be as that pendulum approaches you. And growing your protection is a way of saying you are going to become alerted even more quickly, right? So if a negative person comes to me in my environment, let's say I'm driving my car and I do something stupid and somebody pulls up next to me and honks and starts cussing and you know. Now, if I am mindlessly going about my reality, I don't see myself, I don't see my reality, and I let that situation just open up and I lose energy, This is exactly what keeps us on these lower lifelines. If I can see that person and acknowledge instantly, okay, there it is, right? And then go about protecting myself and my energy levels, then I have the power to get up to some of these higher lifelines. This is exactly my little visual that I have in my mind. My energy is precious and valuable, and I'm going to protect it, and I'm not going to let things into my layer of reality that are constantly looking to compromise that, right? So this is it. How to protect yourself from negative energy attacks. Let me know if you guys get it. If you have any tips or tricks for other people that are struggling with negative energy attacks, put them in the comments below and let me know your thoughts. And I will see you all tomorrow. Bye, guys.